And so let's go ahead and move on to topic number one for the Movie News Roundup show. And it looks like we're going to be having another sequel on the way for Hocus Pocus. When this came out in 1993, I was 9 years old. And I had a good time with this right here. And it's confirmed. I have the report from comicbook.com. It says Hocus Pocus 2 confirmed for 2022, and the original stars are returning, and I could not be happier. The beloved Sanderson sisters are preparing to fly once again in 2022 as the highly anticipated sequel to Hocus Pocus is finally on the horizon. Disney announced that Hocus Pocus 2 was in the works at Disney Plus original movie last year, but that was previously the only information given. Now on Disney's National Streaming Day, the company has confirmed a release year for Hocus Pocus 2 and revealed that the original stars are coming back. Hocus Pocus 2 will debut in 2022, and it will feature the return of Bette Midler, Sarah Jessica Parker, and Kate Najami. Larry, I'm coming to you first, man, but what you laughing at over there?
You got a super chat, my brother.
Oh, super okay. Chat asking about the Be Every OnlyFans.
Oh, my God. Hold on. Let me adjust. Thank you so much, BLHDBS, $50 super chat, Be Avery OnlyFans subscription. Thank you. See, y'all are crazy.
See, this is the great thing about your subscribers, man. You have people on one end. Last week we had a dude that was all upset because you played Where the Money Resides. He was like, here's a super chat, but I don't want that moist dude up in there anymore.
Right.
And this week you got somebody telling you that you're sexy as hell, and another person telling you they want your OnlyFans page. Right, man, everybody in there.
Maybe. I got the whole shebang, man. That's a blessing. I'm happy.
Exactly.
I am happy. Know? No exactly. Complaints. But Larry,
360 love, baby. 360 love. I think a Hocus Pocus. You know, I'll be honest with you. When I watched it the first time, I thought it was funny. I enjoyed the movie, and then I kind of went away and forgot about it. And I can't say that it was anything that I was like, oh, I can't wait for a sequel. I mean, if it comes out, I mean, I like Bette Midler. You know, Sarah Jessica Parker was, you know, she's cool. I'll probably watch it if it's on Disney Plus. I'm not going to go to the theaters or pay for it, but I'll watch it if it's on streaming.
I got you. I thought you was going to trash this, but I'm surprised you said that. One Tech Big Dog, I'm curious, man, because I was 9 when this came out. And so I'm curious, have you seen the film, the original? What do you think about this news? And do you have any interest in it?
Yo, this is my favorite Halloween movie. I
watch
this movie every single year. Like on Halloween, it's like a Halloween tradition for me to like watch this movie every single year. I couldn't be happier because like I have so many fond memories from the first one. Came out in 93. I think I was just born when it came out. So
like, yeah, y'all really making me feel old, damn.
Yeah. And I think it works because, like, yo, these are witches, and they were older then, and so these actresses have gotten older now, but it's only going to play into the film, so it really doesn't, like, take away from anything. They age with the film. So, yeah, I'm absolutely loving this. And unlike Larry, whether this comes out on streaming or in theaters, I'm going to check it out.
All right. And before I come to you, Lamont, let me read this quote, because they're changing directors. As heartbroken as I am that I won't be able to direct my friends, Betty, Sarah, Jessica, and Kathy, and what is sure to be nothing short of a major event in Disney Plus due to scheduling conflicts, I couldn't be more pleased to be handing over the reins to Anne, who has brought so much laughter and joy into people's lives with her previous work, Shankman said in a statement. I am still grateful and proud to help shepherd this ingenious project as executive producer alongside producer Lynn Harris, whom I have loved and admired, as a colleague and a friend since she helped me get the job choreographing Boogie Nights. And they're speaking of Anne Fletcher is going to be the director. This is her right here. If you go over to her filmography, she has done some Varsity Blues, This Is Us, Hot Pursuit, The Proposal, 27 Dresses, and Step Up, which is a franchise that I do like. But I'm coming to you now, Lamont. How you feeling about all this news, man, with Hocus Pocus 2?
This is good for you.
Okay. Chill out. Y'all tripping.
How do I?
Let me grab it real quick.
Yeah,
Man, Jay Bradby.
It resides in my bank account. If you know, it resides in my banking and my money and my wallet. But thank you so much, Ocean's Truth and Wisdom. And what's up, Strictly Starlight? Lamont, go ahead, man.
Okay, go ahead, man. Now, I had some crazy stuff I could have said, but I'm not. You know why I'm not going to say it? Because I'm a fan of Bette Midler. B. Avery, I had never heard of this until you sent this to me in an email yesterday.
Really?
Never. My Halloween tradition is the Garfield Halloween special. I never in my life heard of this. I didn't know anything about it. I had to look it up after you sent your schedule to me. I had to look it up to see what it was all about, where it was going. So if you're asking me, am I going to go see it in theaters? Hell no, I'm not going to go see it in theaters.
Okay.
I don't care how much of a fan I am of the women in it. Are we going to have the real Scarlet Witch in this? Nope. Are we going to have the other chick that was in the WandaVision show in it? Nope.
Wow, okay.
And so for those reasons, I won't be seeing it until it come on stream for free. Now, I did read that it was great.
Yes.
I mean, everything I read said this thing was wonderful. It was bananas. It's a classic.
It's a fun, silly movie, yeah.
But because I have no history with it, I'm not engaged with it. So I'm just going to wait like Larry's doing.
Okay. One second.
I'm taking these sisters over Wanda, Agatha, whoever else.
What?
Doctor Strange, whoever. I'm taking these three sisters over them all day, every day.
I mean, you act like they bewitched. I mean.
Man, that's shocking. Well, just real quick, I just, you know, we're talking about where the money reside. It made $44 million worldwide. Mm-hmm. And you're like, well, it don't know, it ain't no budget right there. But I think I have it here. Yo, the Wikipedia. The budget was, where is it at? $28 million. So it lost money, unfortunately. You know, what does that say? It needs to make
three times
80 something. And so unfortunately it didn't make any money, but it was a 93. It was fun, you know. If they bring it back, just don't spend as much money on it, you know. And I think it'll be okay. But Lamont, since you said you never heard of it, bro, it's really just a silly, goofy Halloween movie. You know, I mean, that's the best way to describe it right there. And it was fun, you know.
But,
and,
you know, this market is a better place for female leads. And so to have a female ensemble cast like that, I think it'll probably do better in this era, in this time, than it did back in the 90s.
Right on. Plus, I feel like it was kind of like a cult classic now, too, for a lot of people.
And if you add elements of all the things we've seen with grunge, kind of the witch culture, if you add some of those elements to this movie, you might get, I could see it being a $1 billion movie, honestly, if you can get all those moving parts correct. I think it could be a big movie.
I don't think it's gonna be a $1 billion movie, and here's why. It's because it's a comedy, and comedies don't translate well internationally. They that just generally don't. A lot of the jokes that are made are because of cultural references. And when you go to places like China and India and some places in Europe, the cultural references don't make sense to people. And just so their jokes fall flat.
All they got to do is take this movie to China, anywhere else, and say, and change the language, say, we hate America. Everybody will turn out to be a billionaire. Come to America.
Bro, that's true.
Every other word.
That's really true.